Alright guys, so that covers backups as well. And finally, the last thing I'm going to show you to end the video is how to pass through Unraid. I know some of you are using Unraid, well I'm still using Unraid as well. And a few comments last week might have been, you know, a little bit unsure, we didn't make it clear, and they may have got the impression that we are completely walking away from Unraid. That's not the case at all, guys. We love Unraid, and we still use it side by side with this setup. We're just expanding our content. So we still use it, and we still have it running, and we really enjoy it. We're just showing some more options for those who are looking for them, and the community response was pretty clear. They love seeing more options, so that's what we're doing. So let's say we wanted to pass through a virtual machine so that we can get Unraid going. How do we do that? So I showed you earlier how to actually configure the virtual machine options when we click Create VM. The first things first, I'll show you the hardware that we've got configured. Under hardware here, we've got memory, so 4GB of RAM, a dual core processor. And the reason is this isn't our live Unraid server. I'm just doing this to show you guys how we can set it up. So if it's going to be your actual Unraid server and you want it running through Proxmox, give it the resources that you want. And the same thing applies here. Give it the processor that is the host. So if we go down and we select host, go OK. You give that the host. Scroll down further. So these are the virtual disks I've allocated to the VM for the purposes of this video. And so you would select the disks that you have on your actual server. Now in my case here, I've got a 50 gig that has some different settings. And the reason is that's our cache disk. If we click edit, you can set that to write through and then discard. If you check advanced, you can also select SSD emulation. Now, if you know that the disk is on an SSD, then you can emulate that directly into the VM. In your case, you may not have a virtual disk. You may have actually passed through a physical NVMe or SSD disk, which is your cache. In that case, make sure you select SSD emulation here. Once you're done, go ahead and click OK. The other thing we need to add is a USB. As you know, if you're using Unraid, it runs on a USB. So go ahead and click add USB device and then select the device from the list. Here's mine here. So we would select Cruiser Fit. And one final thing that we'll do before we start the virtual machine is the boot priority. So if we then go to options and under boot order, we'll select that, click on edit and then find the USB that we passed through, which is right here. Check it as enabled and then move it up to the top. Now I think we're pretty much ready to start this up. Let's see how it looks. Click on start and then open the console. So here we go, Unraid OS starting. So straight away the USB has been detected. Now in our scenario here, the IP address that Unraid is actually living on is our old IP address that has now been reassigned elsewhere. So what we can do is reboot it again and then select the GUI mode and we'll change the IP address that way. And so what I had to do was just boot into the GUI mode off the USB, change it here, and now I can access it through our browser. So what I'm going to do just to get out of the GUI mode is actually just reboot it again. And here we are in our normal browser. We can now access it via the network and it should all just carry on as we were. Of course, you're talking about different disks if you've already formatted your disks or anything like that. So it's up to you how you want to set this up. The important thing is though, this gives you an actual place to test new releases of Unraid and other sorts of OSs without harming your main system. So if you're still running Unraid as your main server and that's your host, that's perfectly fine. Maybe you have a small server sitting at home that you can set up with Proxmox just to test stuff out without harming your main system. The alternative is, of course, you can run those VMs directly on Unraid too, but the Proxmox options to give you backups and things like that may be beneficial for you so that you can back up a release before testing it.